Let There Be Cowgirls. This is the break coming out of the lead, and then the last chorus. The break coming out of the lead is just the same four notes as usual, just hitting it once. Does it again. That's all the same. Then it's going to pop into the chorus, and you're going to do add some funkiness in there. Again, I wouldn't worry about getting it note for note. The only thing that's going to be different is after the second time, it's going to add this riff. So that's on the D string, 4th fret. 4-2-4-6 4-2-4-6 2 and then 4 on the A string. So 4-2-4-6-2-4 So it's kind of like this. Basically the same thing, and I think at the end, when there's the lead playing on it, that little, it's like a little melody lead, same as the intro, you're going to want to do that with it every time, I think. We're going to have to experiment if it, but you might want to put that in every time. I'm trying to think how many times, it's like four times it goes through these patterns at the end, so I'm going to just play along with it real quick. Difference in there, you got those breaks, as I said before, those 1, 2, 3, 4. The ones coming out of the verses are on the A string. These are on the E string. And then on the very last one at the end of the song, it's goes open E, second string on the B. I think you should be able to get the rest of it on that, but like I said, I wouldn't be too concerned with any note for note runs on this thing, as long as you're you'll be fine. That's it for that song.